Hello students, today we will study about the enzyme biotechnology which involves the methods of enzyme immobilization. Now what is enzyme immobilization? It is the imprisonment of any kind of enzyme in a distinct matrix. The matrix on which the enzymes are immobilized that allows the exchange of the medium containing any kind of substrate, any kind of effector or inhibitor molecule. Aminoacylase was the very first enzyme which was immobilized for the production of L amino acids in Japan. Now, what are the advantages of the enzyme immobilization? Why we do the enzyme immobilization? It increases the functional efficiency of the enzyme. It enhances the reproducibility of the process. We can also reuse the enzyme. Continuous of enzyme is also there. Less labor input in the process, minimum reaction time, less contamination of the products, and the stability of the product is also more. Next, there are also the disadvantages. What are that? It is cost effective, high cost for isolation of the enzyme, high cost for the purification of the enzyme, and mainly the recovery of active enzyme is also costly. Catalytic properties of some enzymes are reduced or completely lost after immobilization. Some enzymes become unstable, and also there is industrial applications are limited. Now we talk about the classification of the matrix. What kind of different types of matrix we use for the enzyme immobilization? It depends upon the chemical composition. It is first is organic matrix, second is inorganic matrix. In organic matrix, there are two types. First is natural polymers, second is synthetic polymers. In natural polymers, we use mainly that are compatible with the proteins. Example is like polysaccharides contains agar, agarose, cellulose, dextran, extra. In proteins, it includes collagen, albumin and carbon. In synthetic polymers, it shows high chemical and mechanical stability. So we always prefer the synthetic polymers for this process. It contains polyacrylamide, polyamides, polyacrylate kind of polymers. Next is inorganic matrix. In inorganic matrix, natural minerals, example bentonite, charcoal, silica, processed minerals like metals and metal oxides. Next, what are the methods of immobilization? There are five different methods of immobilization. First is adsorption. It is the oldest and simplest method. In this method, enzyme adheres to the surface of the water insoluble carrier matrix. The binding is non-specific, like electrostatic or hydrophobic affinity binding to a particular ligand. Binding between enzymes to the carrier matrix is usually firm. But weakened by many factors like addition of substrate, pH of or ionic strength, bonding is non-permanent. It is the picture of adsorption. Adsorption by hydrogen bonding it is showing and adsorption by van der Waal forces. Next is what is entrapment method. Entrapment method is the second kind of method used for the enzyme immobilization. In this enzyme entraps, as the entrapment name suggests, enzyme traps inside a polymer or a gel matrix. This method is also known as lattice entrapment. The bonding between an enzyme and matrix can be covalent or non-covalent. The matrix used is water soluble. Example like cellulose, triacetate, agar, gelatin. Methods of enzyme entrapment, it involves inclusion of enzyme. Like we can use gels, we can use fibers, we can use also microencapsules. It is the picture as shown in inclusion in gel, inclusion in fiber and inclusion in microencapsules of the enzyme in different matrix. What is encapsulation? It is the third kind of method used for enzyme immobilization. It is the method which is membrane confined method. Enzyme combines with the semi-permeable membrane of a capsule in an aqueous solution. This process allows the exchange of medium but not an enzyme. What kind of matrix are used in this? The matrix is पॉलीमर मैट्रिक्स, लिपॉयड मैट्रिक्स, नॉन आयनिक मैट्रिक्स. एग्जाम्पल्स आर सेमी परमिएबल मैम्ब्रेन लाइक नाइट्रोसेलुलोज और नाइलॉन. वट आर दी डिफरेंट मैथड्स यूज फॉर एनकैप्सुलेशन? एनकैप्सुलेशन बाई होलो फाइबर मैम्ब्रेन इन्वॉल्व एंट्रैपमेंट ऑफ एंजाइम इन साइड अ सेमी परमिएबल मैम्ब्रेन. सेमी परमिएबल मैम्ब्रेन कैन बी ऑफ सेलुलोज, ट्राइएसिटेट. इन दिस एंजाइम ट्रैप्स इन साइड द स्पेस ऑफ द मैट्रिक्स. माइक्रो एनकैप्सुलेशन बाय केमिकल पॉलीमराइजेशन. एंजाइम मॉलिक्यूल्स एनक्लोज इन साइड अ माइक्रो एनकैप्सूल बाय द यूज ऑफ वेरियस लाइक डाई अमीनो हेक्सेन. एनकैप्सुलेशन बाय लाइपोसोम्स. इन दिस द एंजाइम बाइंड्स टू द कंसेंट्रिक लिपॉइडल मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ द लाइपोसोम बाय द यूज ऑफ फॉस्फोलिपिड. Next, fourth method is covalent binding. It is a widely used method. In this method, enzyme molecule binds to the carrier by covalent bond. As the name suggests, covalent bonding. The binding strength is very powerful. A complex formed through this kind of bonding is very stable. There is no enzyme loss during the process. This is a very big advantage of the covalent bonding. That's why covalent bonding is widely used method. Covalent binding occurs between the active part, that functional group of an enzyme, and carrier molecule. Functional group take part like amino, COO, alcohol group, SH group, O, etc. Example of a polymer carrier used in this: carboxylic acid and related groups of polyglutamic acid, amide group of a polypeptide, amino and related group of polysaccharides. Some mostly common used polymers are polysaccharide, agarose, saffrose, alcohol, silica, and porous glasses. Now, examples of polymer carrier used: carboxylic acid and related groups of glutamic acid, amide group of a polypeptide, amino and related groups of polysaccharides, etc. Next is cross-linking. Cross-linking method is also known as copolymerization. In this, immobilized enzyme covalently linked to the various group of an enzyme via polyfunctional reagents. It does not require a support matrix. Cross-linking leads to the formation of different 3D linked cross-linked aggregates. Commonly used polyfunctional agents are glutaraldehyde, diazonium salts. What are the advantages of this method? No enzyme leakage or very low enzyme leakage. Higher enzyme stability. It is a simple and cheap method. Widely applicability in commercial production. But there are certain disadvantages that are not so cost effective. Causes enzyme inactivation, and polyfunctional reagents cause denaturation. It is the picture in this that covalent binding, cross linking, entrapment, encapsulation, adsorption. We can see that how the enzyme binds to the substrate for the enzyme immobilization. Now there are various applications for the enzyme immobilization. What are the uses of the enzyme immobilization? First point is, it is widely used in industrial production for the production of antibiotics, amino acids. Second is for biomedical application, that is for diagnosis and treatment of diseases. Third is, in the food industry it is also widely used. Example that the enzyme celluloses, pectinases are used for the production of jams, jellies, etc. Product next is for production of biodiesel from vegetable oils. We can also manage the wastewater management by using different enzymes. In textile industry, it is used for the biopolishing and desizing of the fabrics. And in detergent industry, for the removal of dirt from the clothes, it is also widely used. Thank you.